Authorities confiscate over 64,000 pieces of illegal firecrackers worth over 1 million pesos. Philippine National Police spokesperson Colonel Jean Fajardo said these firecrackers were immediately destroyed.
Natin immediately ay talagang nakakailang sira na po tayo, destruction na po tayo ng mga nakukumpiska pong firecrackers. At yan naman po ay ginagawa po natin in public view po. Baka po makita po nila na talagang sinisira po yan at hindi po pinakikinabangan ng ating mga pulis.
So far, authorities have recorded one stray bullet victim. A child in Bukidnon Province sustained a gunshot wound to the hand, but he is now in stable condition. The East Avenue Medical Center has reported its first firecracker-related injury this year, and Quezon City Police destroyed over 500,000 pesos worth of illegal firecrackers. Job Manahan joins us live with the details. Job, good afternoon, and how is it going there now?
Good afternoon, Rika. The East Avenue Medical Center has reported the first case of a firecracker-related injury, and this has been attributed to the mishandling of a fountain firework. Dr. John Paul Lair, the hospital spokesperson, told ABS-CBN that the victim is an adult female who had burns on her face. She has since been discharged. The doctor noted abrasions on the patient's eye. The hospital is already prepared for the New Year celebration. The official said those injured by firecrackers who are exhibiting COVID-19 symptoms will have a specialist area.
Meron na kaming isa, first case namin last night. So it happened around 11:45 p.m. So it involves yung fountain. So sinindihan siya, tapos nung pagkababa niya, bigla na lang pumutok. So may tama sa muka at saka sa braso yung naging biktima. We are already prepared. We already set up the fireworks-related injuries area. Both for dalawang setup namin, isa para sa mga walang respiratory symptoms. Tapos, yung isa para sa mga respiratory symptoms kasi ayaw nating ihalo yung mga patient, lalo na meron pa rin kasi tayong banta ng COVID.
Meanwhile, the Quezon City Police District has destroyed over 500,000 worth of confiscated illegal firecrackers as part of the local government's ban. CCPD Director Nicolas Torres asserted some items that have been destroyed included plapla, fountain, cinturon likuda, lucis, Super Lolo and PT. The move aims to prevent firecrackers.
Hindi natin pinapayagan na kung sino-sino na lang at kung saan-saan na lang binibenta at tinitrade ang mga paputok na ito. Nakita na natin ang destructive na effect nito. Nakakita na tayo ng mga sunog na talagang...
The Department of Health has recorded a total of 41 fireworks-related injuries nationwide from December 21 until Friday. That's 52% higher from the same period last year. President Ferdinand Marcos Sr. earlier encouraged local government units to just hold the common fireworks display area to usher in 2023. And that's the latest here in Quezon City, Job Manahan.
Thank you so much, Job Manahan. Let's check the situation now in major travel hubs in Metro Manila as last-minute travelers head home for the year. Our correspondent Johnson Manaba joins us with the latest. Johnson, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Rita. The Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange for PITX are still open to accommodate passengers heading to their provinces in time for the New Year celebration. According to the PITX management, bus flights will still be available on New Year's Eve, but operations will be limited. But compared to the numbers of passengers yesterday, the management is expecting much lesser today since most of the regular passengers went home already since Thursday and yesterday. Jason Salvador, PITX spokesperson, said they are preparing for the returning passengers on January 2 or after the New Year celebration. The PITX is one of the three intermodal terminals in the south of Metro Manila, covering the areas of EDSA, Baclaran, and TAP, and offering travel to nearby provinces. According to Salvador, the PITX regular passengers average around 65,000 to 70,000, but surge to 90,000 before the volume of passengers in PITX picked up 125,000 last December 23rd, the highest number the terminal has seen during the pandemic. Salvador said people travel more before Christmas and before the New Year, as workers have more days off work and prefer spending the holidays in their hometown in the provinces. Rica.